Google has released several new free features which are available now for your Google Pixel. I'll be reviewing these new features on my Google Pixel 7. Now, all features discussed in this update video are actually also available for other Android phones. And a couple of the features discussed are also available for iPhones. First, much like in my previous Pixel update recap video, the biggest update this month is with Gemini. Google announced back in April that Gemini Live with screen sharing and live camera, which previously required a paid subscription of Gemini Advanced or a Google Pixel 9, will now be made available for free to all Android phones running Android 10 or newer, and have at least 2 GB of RAM, as well as to iPhone users via the Google Gemini app for iOS. Gemini Live with Camera lets you share what you're seeing in a Gemini Live conversation, and thus lets you talk to Gemini about what you see and ask questions. To start it, open Gemini, tap the Gemini Live button, and then tap the camera icon at the bottom. Gemini Live with screen sharing is similar, but as the name suggests, you share what you see on your phone screen and use that as context. Start this mode by opening Gemini, then tapping the Share Screen with Live button. Then confirm you'd like to share your screen with Google. With this, you could, for example, ask Gemini to summarize what you're looking at, or try to explain something on your screen. However, as with all AI, hallucinations and mistakes happen, so I'm going to continue to recommend you double-check everything yourself. Gemini can now also edit photos in-app. After sharing or adding a photo to a Gemini conversation, you can ask it to modify or add to the photo. You can then further refine your modifications using additional text prompts. However, the edited photo appears to be very low resolution in my experience. This photo, for example, went from a 12-megapixel photo to a 0.8-megapixel photo. Photos modified with AI will also be noted with a visible Gemini AI watermark in the bottom right corner, as well as an invisible Synth ID digital watermark, which is noted here when viewing this AI-edited photo in the Google Photos app. The Google Find My Device app has now been renamed to Google Find Hub. The Find Hub app is the app where you can locate and ring your other Android devices, Bluetooth trackers like Chipolo's, as well as view and share your location with others. With this app recently gaining the ability to add Bluetooth trackers and location sharing, I imagine the previous name of Find My Device wasn't accurately describing everything this app can do now. Google's Find Hub app appears to be Android's answer to Apple's Find My app, being the hub for locating your devices, things, and friends in one app. Google's research AI assistant tool, NotebookLM, is now available as an app which you can get for your Google Pixel. It's also available for other Android phones as well as for iPhone. This app lets you bring this AI-powered research tool on the go, and works by having you uploading source documents for a topic you'd like to study or research. These source documents can be PDFs, websites, YouTube videos, or just plain text. You can then chat with these source documents, as well as generate a podcast to listen to a summary of the content. This seems like it could be an interesting tool to help study or research a topic, though as with all AI-powered tools, remember to double-check everything. And that's a recap of what's new for Google Pixel and Android users. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like this video, and consider subscribing for more content like this. Thanks for watching. Until next time.